This lion has been bred as a Cortina eater. The car is the Peugeot 305, designed by the French company to take on Ford at their own big game of building Europe's most successful medium-sized family saloon. It's an important car, important to Peugeot because it plugs a gap in their range and gives them a good entry into one of the most competitive parts of the market. But it's significant also in that it provides further confirmation of the way that millions of us in Europe are going to go motoring in future. It's not a fashionable hatchback, and there's no wild technical wizardry about it. It's a straightforward four-door saloon built on the age-old principle of three boxes, one for the engine, one for the people, and one for their luggage. It even looks a bit like other cars, a hint of Ford around the window frames and a definite touch of the BMWs about its hindquarters. No quirky French styling here. And that's the way that for most of us things are going to be. It's the way not only Ford see it with the Cortina, but Vauxhall with the Cavalier, Opel with the Ascona, and Fiat with the 131. Now the Peugeot crystal ball has come up with the same picture. The 305's chief distinction from those other cars is that it's got front-wheel drive. That's not to say it doesn't have other qualities of its own. It does. In fact, in a number of areas, Peugeot have made some impressive advances. It's a very roomy car. Actually, on the outside, it's smaller than a Cortina, but inside, there's marginally more space.
The driver's seat is as far back as it'll go. But despite the legroom, the angle of the back seat and its height, or rather lack of it, become uncomfortable after a couple of hours or so. The boot, too, is a useful size, and by lowering away with the wheel brace, you can get at the spare wheel, which is slung underneath. There are two versions of the 305, a 1300 and a 1500. In both, the engines are mounted transversely and have sockets for plugging into electronic diagnostic equipment.
They're developed from the overhead camshaft unit from the 304, and that's a model which, incidentally, is continuing in production, at least for the time being.
The acceleration of both models is competitive with anything else in their class, and the only disappointment with the cars at speed is the amount of engine noise. Fuel consumption, well, in 250 miles in a 1500, when admittedly I seem to be perpetually late, I average 31 miles to the gallon. The more punctual will do better.
Certainly both these cars feel lively, even if they're not exactly sporty. And on the 1300, you have to rather row it along on the gearbox to make use of such performance as there is. Mind you, that's no hardship, because the gearbox is outstanding, and there's a very light clutch, too. My main complaints about the driving are to do with visibility. There's an area beside this screen pillar here, which is not swept, at least on these left-hand drive cars, by the windscreen wipers. And when you're reversing, it's hard to see the boot from the driving seat, and that makes judging the length of the car difficult.
The suspension is exceptional. An extremely smooth ride is married to excellent road holding with none of that lurching body roll you get with so many French cars. What is particularly creditable is that all this is achieved with what are, by today's standards, positively skinny tyres. No complaints about the brakes either, or the turning circle, which is remarkable for a front-wheel drive car of this size. There are three levels of trim available. This is the 1300 with the middle GR option. The basic GL doesn't have things like the clock or all the parcel shelves and fresh air vents there are here. The 1500, distinguished on the outside by the rubber strip, has different instruments, including a rev counter, and an armrest in the back seat. The sunroof is not standard.
Car design is a slow process of evolution.
We've barely had a decent breakthrough since Carl Benz. So the car of tomorrow is really nothing more dramatic than an improvement made to the car of today. But on that basis, the Peugeot 305 is a genuine car for the future.
So here is a model which has given car design another nudge forward by setting some new standards of refinement and roominess in this all-important medium car class.